my topic will be art of having a balanced work.
Work-life balance, it feels like a myth to me. So it also sounds like a oxymoron. That is like seriously, funny, act naturally, happily married, work-life balance. All sounds the same to me. Good morning, fellow Toastmasters and my dear guests.
Good morning. Good morning.
Today, I'm going to break down, let me just break down this for you. Imagine you're a woman and you're trying to juggle between your career, your family, your friends, health, sleep, and if there is any personal hobbies, if at all you remember any personal hobbies, you're trying to juggle between that. It's like you're in a circus, no one taught you how to juggle, but still you're trying to juggle and all the balls are in fire. It's like real fun, right? My morning marathon starts when my alarm goes off at 5:30. I sleep by 2 a.m. I wake up by 5:30 a.m. It's like I sleep and wake up on the same day. I go to work the previous day and come back from work the next day. And multitasking is like opening all 15 tabs in the same browser and you don't know, you actually forgot what you actually need. So that is how the multitasking which we do or I do. My morning race starts and I start negotiating with my kids for the breakfast they need and lunch I need to pack. Both of them will give a different meal. So I start, I pack the lunch by 7 a.m. And once they leave to school, I start checking my workmates. I keep responding to the workmates and mentally like I'll have a checklist what to do for the day. And here, the actual fun starts when I actually start working. I'll be in a meeting, I'll be nodding my head for someone who's actually explaining the concept for the nth time. We all know what he's trying to say, but still we'll be nodding in the meeting. And my phone will start ringing. I normally don't pick up the call if it is an unknown number, if the number is not being saved. But I can guess who will be calling at this time. So I pick up the call, and the moment I pick up the call, I can hear, "Amma, please bring my science book before my lunch hour." And my daughter, she'll borrow phone from someone. She's like highly acclaimed to give her, she's highly acclaimed to assign me tasks from the school. So when I was like in school, I used to have just one science book for the whole year. I went to her bookshelf and I saw she's having physics part 1, part 2, part 3, chemistry part 1, part 2, part 3, biology part 1, part 2, part 3, and there are also lab manuals, science lab manuals are there. Everything is like untouched, brand new. Even in the right side corner, the name is also, her name is also written in the book. Even that has not been written. I don't know which book to take to the school. So I grabbed all the books and I started writing my paper. And I was attending the meeting over the earphone. I started writing my paper. Here, I am again doing the multitasking, doing a lot of work, poorly doing at the same time. And whenever like you go to work, there is a universal law in all the workplaces. The universal law is like the moment you plan to go from the office, the moment you step out from your desk, immediately some call will be scheduled. Someone will be calling for the meeting. And I'll be halfway to the door and it will be like a radar for my escape plan. So I thought of going home and like immediately a call will be scheduled. I'll come back to my desk with a big smile out of my pain. So the moment I said, when I actually really go home, I assume, let me take some rest. And no, that is not possible. It's because like second shift starts. I have to go prepare the dinner. When I enter the house, I can feel the tornado has touched each and every room of my house. The house will be so much scattered, I can see my husband happily chatting with his friends. My son, like in his Insta. And my daughter is like happily swiping all the tabs, her own tab. And again, they'll come up with a different menu for dinner. My daughter will send a YouTube link. She'd say, let's try this today. She'd say, like, let's try this new dish today. And it's like, I've actually read about me time, self-care, but like honestly, not sure whether all these are really there or not. And as far as the, I did try scheduling that me time between the meetings and whenever I try to pick up my kids. Probably a 30 minutes me time, just to call up my friends, good old friend, and talk with her for at least for 30 minutes. That has never happened. I'll not be able to make it. Something or the other will come up and I'll not be able to make it. But where is that magical me time this day? Probably at 1 a.m. in the night. I'll not be able to bother anyone at that time. So all I do is, like, I thought, like, let me do something productive at least this time for myself. And I started writing this script for the Toastmaster at 1 a.m. in the night. So despite all this, like whatever is happening, we try to juggle the work meetings, workload meetings, and parents-teacher meeting, in-laws' birthdays or anniversaries, and kids' sports day, whatever it is, we try to manage, we try to work and manage all this. And we for sure, we know it is going to fall apart any second. And probably that is the secret of work-life balance. And all we try to do is, like, we try to manage everything. We try to learn how to pretend to have control over all the tasks which we do. For sure, we know bottom line, like deep down, it is like actually held up with a duct tape or a cafe. So we all try to do is, like, in spite of all this, like, let's try to embrace the chaos and celebrate the small success. Probably, like, we can have a hot cup of coffee before it gets cold. Let's try to manage doing that. And let's also laugh over the madness which we undergo. What else can we learn? Thank you. Happy journey for everyone.